As we observe Women's Month, let's tackle women's cardiovascular health. Now, experts say menopausal women are at risk of so-called myocardial infarction or heart attack. We are joined by cardiologist Dr. Raymond Bellio. Dr. Raymond, thank you so much for joining us here at Top Story.
Thank you very much. Good afternoon, Denise and everyone.
Good afternoon. Now, we've read reports, of course, and research that suggests women experience heart attacks differently than men, and beyond the traditional risk factors like, you know, the usual high blood pressure, cholesterol, can you explain how women's hormonal factors, you know, particularly those related to menopause, can impact women's risk of MI?
Yes, actually, myocardial infarction or acute heart attack is presenting to the female differently because they present a typical presentation. We usually have chest pain in general population, those who are having a heart attack. But for female, they present as subtles. No? They present as nausea, vomiting, back pain, jaw pain, even not so common symptoms such as sleep disturbances, anxiety, fatigue. So this type of symptoms would lead to heart attack for female. And usually, female are protected by the hormones, no, during their reproductive years. And when they come to terms of the menopausal state, they tend to have an increase in myocardial infarction, same as those of their men counterpart. And one of the risk factors is definitely the age. For men, they have 45 years old and above would develop myocardial infarction. But for female or women would have myocardial infarction at 55 years old and above.
And as you mentioned, women often experience atypical symptoms of MI compared to men. Can you describe these symptoms and also emphasize why it's very crucial for women to be aware of them?
Yes, education, awareness about these symptoms is crucial for female, especially because female presents atypically. And as such mentioned earlier, the typical presentations such as nausea, vomiting, which is not a regular occurrence for the regular or typical presentation of myocardial infarction of chest pain, these are common to females in sleep disturbances. And did you know that 50% female presents sleep disturbance 4 weeks prior to the development of myocardial infarction versus that of the counterpart of the men. And most of the time, because it is a typical presentation, female would tend to under-recognize these symptoms as myocardial infarction. Hence, the delay in checking up with their doctors for their symptoms.
Dr. Raymond, what's the difference, you know, between, you know, that lack of sleep and just insomnia for some women? Because, you know, a lot of them sometimes could credit it to just that.
Yes. Sleep disturbance or lack of sleep, no, insomnia is a condition already because it is chronic, meaning it happens for a longer period of time already. It happens that it's undiagnosed. No, there are conditions which would lead to the insomnia. Condition of a patient an individual, as opposed to that of just sleep disturbance, wherein it can be caused by some, for example, fear for that day or because they have to deal with a deadline for tomorrow's work. No, so there's a difference between the two.
And also, recent studies suggest that there is a higher mortality rate for women after MI compared to men. What are some potential contributing factors to this disparity, and what could be done or what's being done to address it?
Yes, so there's a delay in presentation. There's a delay in checkup of female to the doctors. Then the age difference. Female tend to present with these symptoms at a later age, at an older age, at 55. Hence, there's already the presence of other comorbidities such as your hypertension, diabetes, high in cholesterol, or dyslipidemia, which would increase the risk of having this myocardial infarction. And I think, no, I've read in some articles that, and usually it happens, no, the presenting symptom of myocardial infarction for female is sudden cardiac death.
So early diagnosis, intervention, very crucial for successful MI treatment. Can you advise? Sorry, doc, go ahead.
Sorry, awareness of the disease itself. And I'd like to say thank you very much, no? At least we're spreading the news, education about myocardial infarction in women. And then, of course, the preventive aspect, meaning we have to change our lifestyle, the way we eat, the way we sleep during the nighttime. No? We have at least 7 to 8 hours of sleep. We don't want to wake up every night because stress hormone tends to increase during nighttime. So we have to rest our body. Then definitely the cardiac disease is a lifestyle disease, meaning smoking habits, no, secondhand smoking is very, very not good for the health. Improper diet, we choose our food, no, healthy food. Always remember the FNRI, Pinggang Pinoy, half of which should be vegetables and fruits, one-fourth should be meat, and one-fourth should be carbohydrates, not the other way around, of one-half carbohydrates or kanin, di ba? And then definitely know your family history because cardiac disease runs in the family. And at least there's a warning sign already. You know that for a fact that you have a family history of early coronary artery disease. At least you can prevent. And for workers, submit yourself to the benefit, no? Employee's benefit of annual physical exam. It's very important that we prevent the disease rather than treat the disease. And then definitely check your doctors regularly.
And lastly, doc, you know, many women really may feel overwhelmed or even anxious after experiencing an MI. Can you share some strategies, tips to help them cope emotionally and mentally after such an event?
Yes, definitely we need someone to talk to, someone to listen to our fears, you know, our thoughts. When you think that you're under stress, or going through something, you involve other people. You tell your closest family member about what you're thinking, what your fears are, or at least consult a specialist. No, take time to take good care of your health. When you're on stress, sit back, relax, inhale, exhale. Deep breathing would help you calm yourself at that moment. Think of things that make you happy. Go on exercise because exercise releases happy hormones that would at least prevent increase in stress hormones, no? That would counteract those stress hormones. And definitely, again, it's always take time to consult with your doctor.
Cardiologist Dr. Raymond Baelio. Doc Raymond, thank you so much for joining us and thank you for those tips.
Thank you.